there wasn't any support. There was a nurse.
For that illness?
Yeah.
When I was in high school, I know a lot of people use the word like gay and lesbian as an insult. Mm-hmm. So I think I would not have felt comfortable openly coming out. It would have led to me being like really sad and excluded.
Yeah.
And I think that's quite common in a lot of schools.
Okay, so I went to high school in Texas, so I couldn't really come out. I was on like the dance team at my school, and they had like an unspoken rule that you couldn't be gay or else like you'd get kicked off.
I was really fortunate to go to a school where we had like a predominant LGBT society. So when I was in school, I didn't have to come out on my own, because I think that often the case is that if you have like a queer person in school, they have to come out on their own and they have to do all of the educating. But it's a lot of emotional baggage, and I feel like it's really mentally taxing to kind of have to explain to people your identity over and over again.
There wasn't like a place where people felt they could go to talk about it. I never would think about coming out at school.
Yeah, no.
It just wasn't a thing.
So I knew I was gay by the age of like 7. But obviously I couldn't really come out then, so I had to like pretend to date a lot of guys in like middle school, which meant like texting.
You came out when you were 18?
Yeah.
And you knew when you were 7?
Yeah, it was a long road.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it sucked.
I think there's a sort of misconception that once you come out, that's it. And from what I've experienced and what some of my other close friends have experienced is that coming out is a continual process. Like, you're always gonna have to come out over and over again in your lifetime, depending on, you know, who you meet, if you, you know, go to a new school, if you enter a new workplace. Like, you're always having to like assess the room.
So my coming out story was kind of boring. I kind of just told all of my friends over text.
I used to feel like, oh, I'm not a lesbian because I don't look like Ellen DeGeneres.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Really.
And it wasn't until
I don't
like,
fancy her. Yeah. And I don't look like her. Not that there's anything wrong with Ellen.
I had like the best friends and best family I could ever ask for, and I was so lucky because I know some people aren't. So it was never a thing of being afraid to tell them. It was kind of because I'm carrying a secret. I felt like once this secret's gone, it was such a big part of me. I was like, once this secret's gone, who am I then? And then I'm starting to actually grow into the gay man I am.
Even though I kind of had like inklings that I wasn't straight, I wasn't prepared to address them, and I didn't actually want to address them, even though I had a lot of online friends who were kind of in the queer community, and they were all kind of like living their best lives, like out here, like I just came out, and I was just like, oh my gosh, like I kind of identified with those people, but I also, something inside me didn't want to. So I guess in that way I had like a lot of internalized homophobia.
I came out at 14 and I dated a girl that I was in love with her. And she was like my best friend, we had sleepovers, but the abuse that we got was horrific.
And also being brown as well, for me in particular, mm-hmm. and gay.
Double whammy.
It's hard, it's hard. And so you want to fit in, and I think sometimes it's compromising one of your identities to fit the other.
I would have just appreciated like anything being talked about in school, because it wasn't talked about whatsoever. Being gay, being talked about in a way that isn't shameful and that isn't awkward, it doesn't make you feel a bit weird about yourself as well.
And even just having a gay teacher, like I had no gay teachers. I didn't know if any of them were gay, none of them were out or anything. And even having a gay teacher in school would have been so cool. Yeah.
Even just saying that, like extending the olive branch and saying queer issues specifically can come to us and we will help you, because I didn't feel like there was any of that kind of support in place at my school.
I think what would have been really cool to be taught in school is like gay rights and the history of it.
You learn about women's history, like women's rights. Why don't we learn about LGBT rights, LGBT history? It was only a couple of like years ago that we were legally allowed to get married. If I knew that and that all this was going on and like queer people were literally at the forefront of all this like history, I'd have felt prouder to come out and be like able to go, I'm a gay woman.